Newcastle 1, Arsenal 0. The goal was looked at 3 times by VAR. That goal stood, but Arsenal fans just don't seem to be able to accept that it was a legitimate goal.
The ball was clearly out of play. Secondly, there was a foul on Gabriel. And thirdly, there should have been an offside call because of the goalkeeper's positioning. Yet somehow it was allowed to pass.
We're 100% sure we see the world the way it is, but the human mind is not a camera. The brain has limited capacity. It cannot compute and process all the information coming in. It always has to prioritize some information and ignore other information. And it doesn't do it randomly. What the brain pays attention to or not depends on who you are, what you want to see, what you expect to see. So two football fans can look at the same event, for example, the same foul, and honestly see two different things at the same time. All of this is without your awareness. This is what we call confirmation bias. This is the power of expectation. It affects everyone, even experts. We've looked at fingerprint examiners who went to court and testified 100% that fingerprints match. We took those same fingerprints, gave it to the same expert, but now told them that the suspect was away and somebody else confessed to the crime, they said the fingerprints don't match now.
Group bias is a way in which we interpret the world in different ways, depending what group we're associated with.
Liverpool, Nottingham Forest. What a game. It was a controversial winner. They had the ball, then our player Kanate got injured, and then once play resumed, instead of the ball being returned to them, as it should have been, I'll admit, the ball was returned to us. Well, that incident happened a full 2 minutes before the goal. So you can't say that that had a direct influence on the goal being scored.
If the ball had actually been left with us, which was the correct decision, that wouldn't have happened. Liverpool simply would not have scored.
We tend to think favourably about people from our own group. So an example of this might be, you know, when we're watching a football match and a foul is committed. We're more likely to say that that foul was committed if it's committed by a member of the opposing team than a member of our own team. We got football supporters of two different teams, Chelsea and Manchester United, to have their brains recorded while they're watching games between the two sides. We looked at the visual cortex, where they actually process visual information, but there's very little difference between the two groups. So it looks like they're actually seeing exactly the same game. But of course they're interpreting it differently, so we decided to have a look at other regions of the brain, and that's where we found the group biases. The reward is really interesting because essentially what it shows us is that there's a really strong drive to be a member of a group because we're getting rewarded for that group membership.
Tribalism. We've always had it, but it's never been as powerful as it is today, and it was really pushed by one algorithm chosen by these platforms. All of them use the friends of friends to grow. Meaning, in my country, when Rodrigo Duterte became president, right, we were still pretty much in the center, but in 2016, if you were pro-Duterte, you moved further right. If you were anti-Duterte, you move further left. 2017, 2018, 2019, and the radicalization went with recommendation engine.
confirmation bias is not intentional. If you have an expectation, it's going to impact what you see. You cannot just block it out, but we can minimize them to a large degree. For example, if you're hiring somebody for a job and you really want to hire the best person, you minimize those biases by not knowing their name, their race, if it's a man or a woman, all this irrelevant contextual information that will cause you to misinterpret and bias the actual data for hiring them.
An important aspect of guarding against group bias is to interact with people who are not in our group, try and understand them as individuals, and try and understand their ideas.
It's very important when we're talking about forensic experts, medical experts, politics and world conflicts to minimize the biases. When we're talking about football and sports, as long as it's friendly, why minimize it? Enjoy the rivalry, enjoy your biases.